Hello to all. In this video lecture, I discuss a very important topic and further correlate the same with the activity of drug or the drug action. So you can see here the topic which I am going to discuss today is stereochemistry and drug activity. So, as you can see here, these both topics are ultimately belongs to different specialization or the different field of science. And as you can see here, the stereochemistry is correlated, or it is one of the most important aspect of organic chemistry. And we are going to correlate this stereochemistry with the drug activity, which is a key feature of the pharmacology as well as an important topic related to the pharmaceutical chemistry as well as medicinal chemistry. So I am going to discuss both this topic, how ultimately the stereochemistry is responsible for the drug activity. So before moving further, I here want to further emphasize some important concept so that the whole scenario of this video lecture can be well cleared and is further is easy to grip. So what is ultimately the stereochemistry is? Stereochemistry means, in a very simple form or in a very smart words, stereochemistry is nothing but the three-dimensional arrangement of atoms of a molecule within a space. And you can see here, here you can ultimately see here that this is a molecule. Which I represented here by ball and stick notation, and this ultimately represents that in this molecule there is a different or there is a three-dimensional arrangement of atoms are there. Now what ultimately the drug activity means? So the drug activity is something which is crucially be correlated to the pharmacodynamics as well as the basic mechanism how the drug shows its action. So we are ultimately correlating here, in a more simpler words, we are also correlating here the structure to the activity of a drug in a very simpler manner. So let us know how ultimately the stereochemistry is responsible for the activity of drug. So let us say this is the three-dimensional structure of a molecule, which is a very renowned drug. And this molecule, in order to show its action, have to bind with certain receptor. Now this is the very basic thing which I am saying here. each and every drug molecule, if it has to show its action, it's primarily have to bind with certain receptor. And unless until the molecule or any drug molecule is unable to bind, or how potential it is bind, on the basis of which the overall output or the drug activity is depending upon. So let us say this is the drug molecule, and this molecule, in order to show its activity, have to bind with the receptor, that is the receptor 1 and the receptor 2. So these both are, I here mentioned two receptors to which this drug molecule has to bind. And let us, we know how this binding of this drug molecule with the receptor ultimately affects its activity. So as you can see here, this is the arrangement of atom within this particular molecule, and we have to here able to see there are two receptors, and these two receptors have a different configurations. Now we have to correlate how the activity is achieved. So let us look into the very first case, when this configured molecule or this particular molecule, if it is allowed to bind with the receptor 1. So here in this case, as you can see here, the chances of binding of this drug molecule with the receptor 1 in this particular configuration is comparatively more. And why it is more? This is because the atoms which are ultimately we here mentioned as the A, B, C, D are very easily to get fixed or set in the pockets of the receptor, as both the drug as well as the receptor have the similar configuration. You can see here. So whenever this drug molecule binds with the receptor 1, it will shows a better and a prominent action. Or we can say on binding of this drug molecule with receptor 1 will shows a very good activity. Now let us discuss the second case, and as you can see here, this drug molecule, if it is allowed to bind with the receptor 2. Now if we see the configuration of this drug molecule, and we ultimately emphasize the configuration of this receptor, you can see here that there is a difficulty in binding of this drug molecule with this particular receptor 2. And the reason behind this is incompatibility of pockets which are present in the receptor. As you can see here, if I will compare this drug molecule, a structure of this drug molecule with this receptor 2, only one atom of this drug molecule is ultimately able to bind with the pocket P1, and other atoms, to certain extent, the atom B of this drug molecule is also able to bind with the pocket P3, as you can see here. So only two pockets of this receptor is able to bind with this drug molecule in case of receptor 2. However, the two atoms are ultimately unable to bind with the receptor 2, and hence they are unable to show its action. So this is the reason why or how the stereochemistry ultimately affects the activity of drug. So I summarize here in a very short way. If a drug is having or getting a compatible binding with any receptor, or if a drug is able to tightly bind with a receptor, whatsoever it may be, the drug is able to show its prominent activity. And in another case, if the drug is unable to bind with the receptor very tightly or with a very good binding, in such a case, where this is not a case, or where the drug is unable to bind with the receptor with full affinity, in such a case, the drug is unable to show its action. So this is how the stereochemistry ultimately affects the activity of drug. And we can also here say, or in a similar sense, we can say how the structure of any organic compound, or how a structure of a molecule or a drug molecule affects its activity or biological activity.